Hi, I'm Kurt David, host of the show From Glory Days. Please join me and watch the stories of Hall of Fame, All-Star, World Champion, and former professional athletes as they've transitioned from the pinnacle of their pro sports careers back to normal, everyday lives. Today's guest was a two-time college All-American at the University of Miami, a first-round NFL draft pick by the Baltimore Ravens, and developed into one of the best linebackers of all time. During his 17-year career, he won two Super Bowl championships and was awarded a Super Bowl MVP. His passion for football is only superseded by his desire to give back, and you can find him often attending charity events and anything that empowers young adults. We caught up with our guest at such an event in Seattle. My guest today, Ray Lewis. When we come back, you'll hear Ray explain how he went from tackling opponents to tackling some of the biggest challenges professional athletes face.
From Glory Days, with your host, Kurt David.
Professional athletes give everything to win the game. After their glory days, most professional athletes want to give back to their communities. United Athletes Foundation helps athletes focus on their visions and support causes that are important to them. With a remarkable background and impressive stats, Great Lakes Capital Fund is the perfect teammate capable of making big things happen. With this team, everyone wins.
Genosco Development Company is a real estate development firm specializing in the creation and preservation of quality housing. GDC, through its subsidiaries and joint ventures, engages in the acquisition, development, ownership, and operational oversight of multifamily communities.
GDC aligns itself with a team of experts that believe every property should serve as an economic and social catalyst to the community.
GDC communities are known for their careful planning, attention to detail, and respect for the environment.
I'm Kurt David, joined by NFL legend Ray Lewis. Ray, thanks so much for being on the show. Two-time college All-American, NFL Defensive Player of the Year twice, 10-time first-team All-Pro, 13 Pro Bowls, two-time Super Bowl champion, Super Bowl MVP. Yeah. With credentials like that, an athlete could play any sport they wanted. Why football?
Well, I think football probably chose me. Yeah?
What do you mean?
Growing up in my where we was from, we were limited on
your choices and options.
Absolutely, the things you had access to, and so you had to find out very quickly what your niche was.
And at what point did you find out that was your niche?
Well, you don't really find it out until it actually when I said it chooses you. Mm-hmm. It chooses you for a certain reason because my favorite sport was probably wrestling. That was my
favorite.
You were
very good at it.
Yeah. Because I love one-on-ones, mm-hmm. right? And so I was in love with wrestling before anything. I was like, God, wrestling. But football was the ticket to college and the way out of the situations that we were in, bad neighborhoods, different things like that. So, and then when you get to 10th grade, 11th grade, you're like, wow, I really got a chance to go to college.
You have an opportunity.
Yeah.
So you saw it was your ticket. That was
absolutely
your ticket.
Yeah. Absolutely. So when you see it, it's like, okay. And then you started to hone in on certain crafts about it. And when I got into high school, I figured out something very quickly, that being in the game, you didn't have to be the biggest, the fastest, or the strongest. You just had to be totally dedicated to it. Mm-hmm. And I was more dedicated to the effort part of it. Mm-hmm. You know, and so I always was around athletes who was much better than me.
Quicker, stronger.
Yeah, but I never really found too many people that would just beat me in pure effort.
The passion.
Know? Yeah, and then once I figured out that it wasn't really about the sport, it was really about a lifestyle, about really challenging yourself to hone in on different things, to be disciplined with life. Yes, ma'am, still is yes, ma'am. Yes, sir, still is yes, sir, mm-hmm. right? So morals for me, mom has already raised me a certain way. So morals for me is the things I started to really apply to football. I was like, wow, okay, I
get it. Those same kind of attributes and principles.
And so now it's like, so when you read off all of those things, I can only attribute those things to how disciplined I was on the way coming up.
And it paid off, obviously. You talked about the scholarship. You went to the U.
Yeah,
Miami. So had great success there. NFL draft. Let's move forward then into the NFL. Yeah. Great year. 17 years. I mean, it's unbelievable. So for somebody to play that long, for one, but let alone to have the level of success that you had at that point, Ray. What are some of your best memories of football in the NFL?
Well, I think it was really just the opportunity. You know, I grew up as a kid, and in 1985, I was I was able to see at 10 years old, I was able to see the greatness of the Chicago Bears defense and the greatness.
You were a Bears fan at that point.
Well, I was a fan of I was a fan of effort all over again. I was a fan of Walter Payton. I was a fan of Mike Singletary, Will Marshall. I was a fan of Ronnie Lott's. You know, Steve Young was probably my favorite quarterback at the time. Yeah. And so I was a fan of what that looked like. And I was like, wow, like, suppose I get there one day. Yeah. And then so.
So what was it like being there? I mean, you got there and made an impact right away.
Yeah. When it happened, you know, I'm 18, 19 years old. And I'm around some of the greatest of greats, you know, the Reggie
Whites. Some of your heroes, yeah.
The Reggie Whites, the Derrick Thomases, man. I was like, wow. And so when I came into the league, I was having so much fun in the league. I was like, look, I got it. I made it, you know, and so I'm just going to do it. And then Marvin Lewis, he challenged me very early in my career to do what I really, what he saw in my eyes. And that was, you know, he asked me what I wanted to do. And I said, honestly, I want to be the greatest to ever do this. And he was like, greatest what? I said, greatest player to ever scrap up a pair of cleats, period. And he was like, you know what that's going to take, right? And I was like, nah.
Was that your first year or when was
second.
That? Second year in.
Second year. Yeah. And then, because my first year come in, so one of the most exciting parts ever about football was I came in from the University of Miami, but I was just about 225 pounds, right? So I wasn't
light
wasn't
for really, linebacker,
right? Yeah, wasn't really big. And then, so when I got here in the first couple of training camps in Baltimore, really didn't have an identity. You know, we were old Cleveland Browns back to Baltimore, and so we got to Baltimore. So we really didn't have a name or have a reputation about anything. And Marvin, I never forget it. Him and Maxie Vaughn, who was my linebacker coach at the time, they challenged me to do something. They was like, look. The way you play the U, you have to now implement everything you learned there here. Because guys, a lot of guys around here don't know what that feels like.
They don't understand that.
They don't understand winning and understand what it means. And so I got into the mindset of the game very quickly.
Yeah, it sounds like it paid off, obviously.
Yeah.
But we need to take a quick break. When I come back from the break, I'm going to ask Ray Lewis what his hardest hit was in the NFL.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Genosco Development Company, building a brighter future today.
Great Lakes Capital Fund has built a game plan to provide a legendary kind of impact that will facilitate affordable housing to those in need and help build and better the communities that surround them. Together, the United Athletes Foundation and the housing and development experts at Great Lakes Capital Fund have the power of connecting professional athletes' vision, voice, and drive with asset management and strength. With this team, everyone wins.
Big statements are made with actions, not words. Go to the guys that work as hard as you do. Nowatzky Truck and Trailer on US 23, exit 149 in Whitmore Lake. The 24,000 square foot facility performs all service applications on tractors and trailers, light duty, heavy duty, single axle, multi-axle, dump trailers, and walking floors. No job is too big or too small. Nowatzky Truck and Trailer, 734-995-9600. Nowatzky Truck and Trailer. We do it right the first time.
Genosco Development Company is a real estate development firm specializing in the creation and preservation of quality housing. GDC, through its subsidiaries and joint ventures, engages in the acquisition, development, ownership, and operational oversight of multifamily communities.
GDC aligns itself with a team of experts that believes every property should serve as an economic and social catalyst to the community.
GDC communities are known for their careful planning, attention to detail, and respect for the environment.
I'm Kurt David, joined by my guest, Ray Lewis. Ray, what was the hardest NFL hit that you recall that you gave on somebody? What was the hardest hit that you recall?
I just had this conversation not too long ago. I've had a lot of collisions, and I think this is the ones in the open field that they're the easiest to pay attention to. But I think it's the ones that's right in the trenches that was probably the hardest hit. And I'm not proud of what happened, you know, with the result of it. But probably one of my hardest hits was, you know, this guy Rashard Mendenhall played for Pittsburgh, and you know he was this young rookie, and he comes out and he's talking trash. He's not impressed. He's not impressed by what he see on film with me. And we played them in Pittsburgh, and he there was this one play, he got the ball and wind back. And when he was winding back, I had already took off full speed. Oh, my gosh.
You had a beat on him at that point.
Yeah. And when we collided, instantly, the moment I hit him, I knew I had done something. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know what it was exactly. But like I said, I'm not proud of the fact, but, you know, it snapped his collarbone instantly. Mm. But it was the point of that impact. It's the perfect hit that a linebacker dreams for. Mm-hmm. That your feet are square, your hips are low, and it's the right ta. And to me, like I said, I've delivered a bunch of great hits on people, but that one was standing out in my career.
Yeah, and the intent was not to hurt him, but certainly it was a textbook hit. It was the hardest hit, and I guess the jaw led up to it.
Yeah.
You know, you knew he had it coming in that sense, but not the injury, obviously, and that's not the intent of it. So let's talk about, I mean, injuries are part of the NFL, part of it, unfortunately. You know, as you moved along in your career, first of all, what was the top, I mean, what was the best memory that you have? I mean, you've done so much, Super Bowls, MVP. What was the best for you?
The best memory for me, in the game, man, I've had so many, and I haven't really reflected like that yet.
It's hard to list just one.
But yeah.
If you could just say, boy, maybe my top one or two, this is it.
Probably my top one or two, honestly. It would be hard to ever go past both Super Bowls. Yeah, because it's the moment of what I seen right after. And to see my mother's eyes after my first Super Bowl. And to see my kids, and then my last Super Bowl, to see my baby's eyes, and to see my mother's, you know.
The joy.
Yeah, there's nothing.
So that meant more to you than to your own self.
Listen,
it was to see them take that in.
I got rid of self a long time ago. Mm-hmm. You know, every Sunday for me became Mother's Day for me. Mm-hmm. You know, and that's what I played for. Mm-hmm. I played to make sure my mom would smile many a days.
That was your motivation?
Absolutely, my entire life. Mm-hmm. And so that was my greatest highlights playing. I love seeing her face. It was something about her face. Win, lose, or draw, it was something about her face when I came.
Well, Ray, it's safe to say that you made her smile a lot in your career. No question about it. But unfortunately, as we know with every professional athlete, that career at some point does transition.
Yeah.
And for you, it came at a pinnacle. I mean, not too many people can walk away after what you accomplished. But what was that transition for you when you did come out?
It's, you know what? I had already, my mindset was already made up.
What do you mean?
When I tore my tricep, I tore my tricep playing against the Cowboys.
Yeah, for most of the season.
And so I had a lot of time to reflect on the next steps, on what going out will feel like, what going out will look like.
You started that thinking, the thought
process. Yeah, I started a couple of years ago prior setting up different things, but my mindset was ready then, because I was like, okay, I had already promised my kids that year. I had been playing 17 years. I had talked to my daughter, my oldest daughter, my oldest son, and I said, look, you know daddy can't play forever, you know? And I promise you, all of you, that I will be here for you, you know, at the stages of your career, at your lives. And I was like, I've done what I needed to do. There's nothing more for daddy to do in this game.
You were satisfied at that point.
I had done it. And then I had one last conversation, which is conversation that was recorded actually, that I had with my daughter, my oldest daughter, and I said, when do you think daddy should come back? And she said, daddy don't come back in the regular season. She said, come back in the playoffs. And I said, okay, wow. And then I got on the phone with my then owner, Steve Bisciotti, and he was like, Ray, just do something that no many people ain't never done. He was like, if you're gonna come back from the tricep injury, come back, take us through the playoffs, and go win a Super Bowl and then retire.
Couldn't have read a story better than that, yeah.
And I was like, okay, I'm going to do just that.
And you did.
Yeah, and then I made the decision, and then I'm on the goal line against San Francisco 49ers. I'll never forget it. And I looked at my players, and I'm looking to the side, and I'm looking at each and every one of them. And I was like, look, nobody needs to be a hero. One play, four plays, and I'm a champion the rest of my life. Mm-hmm. I can walk away from the game the rest of my life. And instantly, My entire career flashed before me in 30 seconds.
What do you mean?
Everything, every moment I've ever been through
in
my
career. It all accumulated right
every
that
moment. That's how slow those plays was happening. And I'm sitting there, first down, second down, third down, fourth down. And we get the fourth down, and I'm looking at this ball go up, and I'm like, oh my gosh, my career ends like this. Mm-hmm. So then the transition was really, and I don't say this in a disrespectful way to the game, but the transition was at the right point in my life.
They couldn't have planned it any better.
Well, listen, when God orchestrates certain things, it's the way he does it. Mm-hmm. And when I got to that point in my career, I said, it's over.
Yeah.
I done it. So the transition for me was, it was actually way smoother than a lot of guys go through, because a lot of guys were, oh man, I wish I could have played longer.
It was on your terms as a result. Well, we need to take a transition right now, unfortunately, Ray. But when we come back, I'm gonna ask Ray Lewis why it's so important for him to give back.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Genosco Development Company, building a brighter future today.
Great Lakes Capital Fund and the United Athletes Foundation have built a game plan that will create stable and sustainable communities that include affordable housing and economic development opportunities. The United Athletes Foundation helps athletes focus on their visions and support causes that are important to them. And Great Lakes Capital Fund has a superior track record in raising capital and managing communities they invest in. Together, they raise capital to invest in the future. With this team, everyone wins.
Genosco Development Company is a real estate development firm specializing in the creation and preservation of quality housing. GDC, through its subsidiaries and joint ventures, engages in the acquisition, development, ownership, and operational oversight of multifamily communities.
GDC aligns itself with a team of experts that believes every property should serve as an economic and social catalyst to the community.
GDC communities are known for their careful planning, attention to detail, and respect for the environment.
We all experience financial bumps in the road. It's called life. And when financial challenges pop up, LOC team members are here. We specialize in debt relief strategies for our members. With lower fees and better loan rates, you'll realize the best place to do all your banking is at LOC Federal Credit Union. It's time to own your money. Visit us on the web or call to learn more.
Welcome to LOC Federal Credit Union. How can we help?
Yep, with Xfinity Internet, your family can use all their devices at once. Works anywhere in the house, even the garage.
Max, what's going on?
We're doing a tech startup. We're streamlining an algorithm.
What's Grandpa doing?
Hi.
Shh, Grandpa, you don't want to be an intern forever.
Sorry, Dad. We have to get back to work. We have a deadline.
We're going public!
The fastest in-home Wi-Fi for your entire family. Sign up for the X1 Triple Play and get double the speed. Only from Xfinity.
I'm Kurt David, joined by Ray Lewis. Ray, you talked about leaving the game on your terms. What challenges, if any, were there for you, though? This was your whole life, you played football. What were any challenges that you might have faced as a result?
I didn't face many. I didn't.
Emotionally, just walking away from the game that you love, the teammates.
No, the biggest challenge I had was to slow my butt down.
Really? What do you mean by that?
Because I've been going at 100 miles an hour my whole life.
You're passionate. Your whole life.
And I've been training my whole life, mm-hmm. And I just never really gave my body a break. Mm-hmm. I never gave my mind a break. Mm-hmm. So now I see cities differently, mm-hmm. right? I transition and I travel to cities now. And when I used to go to certain cities, I could never see what the cities looked like, mm-hmm. because my blindness was on, my head was down.
You were
focused. I was mad at everything.
Focused,
yeah. All I wanted to do is get in and play the game. Now, it's the simplest things I see. I didn't know Seattle was this beautiful. Mm-hmm. You see? So it's so many
slowed
things.
Slowed you down a little bit.
Yeah, and yeah. So that's what
happened. So that's been a benefit for you as far as
that's
being able to enjoy some of the things.
The transition of the game, to leave the game, now I enjoy life from a totally different perspective
Enjoying
life. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And now, me just sitting at my kids' games, there's nothing greater as a father knowing I don't have to leave my babies now.
Does it get you going when you're watching out there, like, oh, I would have done this or I would have done this?
Nah.
Okay,
now it's all giving them everything that I know.
Speaking of giving, you are a giver. Yeah. And there's no question. Ray Lewis is a giver. Why is it important for you to give back?
My mom.
What do you mean?
It's not a secret. We didn't have much. Mm-hmm. We didn't have much. But she showed me a model. And I've vowed to follow that model. And that model is, I don't need to give you everything you want. I have to make sure you have everything you need. Mm. And my mom gave more to people when we didn't have. And all she did was give. Mm. And I'm telling you, we were completely broke growing up, completely. And to see her giving, to see what she was built from.
In that state, she still was a giver. So she was your model right from the start.
From the start. My greatest, I've had a lot of people that I admire. But my greatest role model on this earth is my mom, because what she taught me, no man could ever give me.
Giving.
Yeah, giving. giving. Don't ever stop giving. And you know, the good book says giving to the poor is like lending to God himself. So when you start to understand scripture and you start to really add it to your life, it becomes a purpose. So my purpose of giving became a purpose of the rest of my life to figure out different ways to give, different ways to help, different ways to encourage, different ways to speak life into people. And so that's what my whole vision started to open up and say, wow, you know what? The game was great, but the game is actually a platform for me to really be able to use what God has given me, which is my ability to give.
Let's talk about that. What, you're giving us so many things. It's a whole laundry list of things. I mean, I heard you even climbed a mountain recently. Tell us about
that. No, I didn't climb
a mountain. You didn't climb it? Oh, okay.
I went over there to climb it. I went over there to climb it. But I snapped my toe in 2010 here in Seattle. So that stops a lot of things. But what I did went over there to Africa to do is these water wells in Tanzania. Mm-hmm. They have a lack of water over there. And so... forget the dollar amount, but I purchased four large wells that we're gonna plant in the ground.
Something as simple as that.
And so that's what it kind of transitioned to the Starkey Hearing Foundation. I kind of got really connected with them and was giving people the ability to hear for the first time in their lives, right? Mm-hmm. And one of the greatest stories I've ever said, 5 second story, is that I saw a father listen, see his child and hear him for the first time in his life. In Africa, and I'm blown away. And so the mission turned into a total mission of, once again, just giving again. And I've been doing a lot of stuff in Africa for many years. But so everything I do is some way connected to something or partnering with this person, trying to make sure that we have to put a dent in America on what it looks like to really help each other, right? Not compete with each other, not make a bunch of money. Like what it really feels like when somebody speaks your name, instantly they can say you helped change my life. That's the reason I live, right? The good book says a great name is rather chosen than all the riches of this earth. I live for a great name. I live to, when I do lay my head cold, don't cry.
You're involved with a lot of great names. One of those is the United Athletes Foundation, and that's why we're here in the hackathon. And tell us more about what it is that you're doing here and what it is that you're here in Seattle on location doing this.
Me and my partner, Reggie, you know, we found a few bumps in the road with our company, but now, you know, our foundation now and what we've built with our company now is showing its face in Seattle right now. For us, you know, you grind as long as you grind and you try to build these things. And when you get here to this hackathon, to where we challenge all of these kids.
Tell us more about it. What is it about?
Yeah,
what are we doing?
Yeah. You challenge all of these kids in a world of social media, right? That can be out of control at times. Mm-hmm. But you channel the right energies. You channel the right mindsets. And you get the right kids together, all these colleges across the world. And you give them a challenge. Come up with the greatest app concept of what you think can help the world in any way, you know, technology driven. And so now, partner with Microsoft, making that connection with Microsoft, then coming here. And when you get here to Microsoft campus and you walk in there and you see that you've given kids an opportunity that they will never have in a lifetime to actually say, we have the ability to do something and everybody might know about it. So this hackathon has went so viral so quick and it went so global so quickly. Because now the calls and the different things that's coming through now is, how can I be involved? How can I be involved? How can I be involved?
I be involved? We're going to find more information.
Well, see, that's our foundation, UAF Foundation. We have a bunch of that stuff on the websites. Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that website?
Yeah, UAF. Mm-hmm. Yeah. United Athletes Foundation. Mm-hmm. And our model was always to give back. Connect athletes to what our brand is. Connect with the modern day world. Connect with business, bring all of that together, and then that's what you see the babies' faces.
Unfortunately, we need to take another break right now, but when we come back, I have a Facebook question for Ray Lewis.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Genosco Development Company, building a brighter future today.
Professional athletes give everything to win the game. After their glory days, most professional athletes want to give back to their communities. United Athletes Foundation helps athletes focus on their visions and support causes that are important to them. With a remarkable background and impressive stats, Great Lakes Capital Fund is the perfect teammate capable of making big things happen. With this team, everyone wins.
I'm Kurt David, joined by my guest, Ray Lewis. Ray, Steve on Facebook asked, you've received many honors for many different reasons. What's the one that means the most to you?
Probably my statue.
Tell us more about the statue.
Yeah, to be honored with a statue. I'm still in my 30s. I've read history enough to realize that, you know.
If you get a statue,
you're there. Something.
And where's that statue at? Well, tell us more about that.
So, Baltimore, right in front of Raven Stadium. Mm-hmm. I share a platform with the great Johnny Unitas. Mm-hmm. It's called Lewis Unitas Plaza. That's what I goes back to. I say a great name is rather chosen because to see my mom's face that day, to see what
again
that,
another motive for you was the Super Bowl, the statue, to see your mom.
You can accomplish a lot of things in life, but I'm telling you, if I challenge kids to do anything, find different ways to make your mom smile, yeah, and God will bless you, just simply by honoring your mother. And to see that statue that day when that tarp came off it, and to know, man, I get chills now. Think about it, because it's something that you don't, you can't envision that. You can't envision that when you're growing up. And that day, you know, I called every person that I could have thought of before I get to all the other stuff that I just wanted to think. Mm. Yeah, that day wasn't about me. It was about the people that helped me get to that point. Mm-hmm. I called some of the...
That was a celebration for those
for
people
For those people,
well.
Yeah. You know, all the way back to Pee Wee football and high school football, high school coaches.
With all those accomplishments and all those years, that list had to be very long.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. I'm telling you, the most humbling thing ever is to sit there and rejoice in that moment with all of those people who know the part that they played in my life. It's one thing to try to tell somebody your story. It's another thing to live your own story.
To live it itself. Yeah. Well, and we know that your story with football, that the transition ended at some point from football. This show is about the transition of professional athletes, but more importantly about transitions in life. What advice would you have for anybody that's going through a change or transition? What would Ray Lewis to say as advice?
Honestly, that there's no difference. The way you win it, the way I win at the game, I go at business as hard as I win at the game. Mm. You know, I study businesses and I study people as much as I study people trying to figure out plays, you know? So it's kind of something I told the kids yesterday, you know, when you see transition really start to happen, when you really want to transition to something, master it. Mm-hmm. There's no limits, you know? Don't let the world ever put limits on you. You can do anything you want to do, but make sure if you have a vision, make sure the vision is written, you know? Make sure you have something to actually chase and not just hoping and wishing and all these different things. So I tell guys this all the time, put your plan together and then work the plan. Mm-hmm. Don't work somebody else's plan, right? It's one thing about the league. I love the league, but the league is somebody else's brand, right? You have to create your own brand yourself. And your brand is whatever you feel like doing, whatever your heart is passionate about, chase it.
Great advice from Ray Lewis. Well, I'm Kurt David, and that wraps up another show. Please join us again next time when we watch the stories of professional athletes unfold from Glory Days.
Presented in part by Genosco Development Company, building a brighter future today.